What's up, Metal Injection Junkies? Rob here along with
Noah
and Frank.
And we're here at the second edition of the 70,000 Tons of Metal Cruise. While the sun is setting on our journey, let's take a look back at what you missed on this year's cruise.
Bit, you know, like a floating vacuum, in that there are so many bands, so many people you know, you can just like sort of, you know, people you haven't seen in years or in a year or something like that.
You get to see like a bunch of fucking metal bands together that, you know, normally in a normal setting you won't see, and here it's just all happening.
So it's very comfortable and it's awesome to hang out with all these people.
Just to mingle with the fans, because normally we don't get that. You know, you're always backstage and shit.
Exactly.
But now you can mingle with the fans. You can, you know, grab a beer together and just have fun. That's what, you know, what it's all about.
Look, you can walk down one hallway and just be like, all right, I'm going to bed, and turn a corner and there's a raging party, and well, I guess I'm not going to bed yet.
You got tons of bands and heavy metal fans and all that, and everybody seems to be really, really happy, in a good mood, having fun, drinking, listening to bands, getting crazy, raising hell, but still, like, everybody's really positive and happy.
The single most frequently heard comment is that these people are very, very nice, very respectful. And is that a surprise? I don't know. But again, this goes back to stereotyping. And how wrong we can be about each other by just judging each other by the exterior. And I think that's the single most beneficial lesson that 850 people from our side will take away from this, and they'll take it with them for a very, very long time. And in this age when we've got so much turmoil going around the world, you know, this is good. This is very, very good. You know, it sort of transcends barriers and frontiers that may have been there, and we just break them down. I wish the rest of the world could do that.
Well, that's all for us. We got to get back to our cabin, pack up, drink some final shots, and get back home. But this was a great time. Guys, what was your favorite band? Frank,
how about you? For me, it had to be Amorphis. That blew my mind, man.
And Noah?
I can't decide. I think Overkill.
Overkill?
I had a lot
Not
of fun.
Moon Sorrow? I mean, you were kind of like, oh, Moon Sorrow!
You know what? I think everyone knows that Moon Sorrow are my favorite. But this was the first time I got to see Overkill, and they were amazing.
It's all about new bands, man. Like, I've never seen Nightwish my entire life, and I thought it was fucking incredible. I thought it was pretty rad, too.
For me, personally, since I know you guys care, it was...
Gravedigger. Was it Gravedigger?
No, I was seeing Suffocation on a boat. No. When are you going to see, like, them... Oh, no, no, no. My favorite specific part is Corpse Grinder introing Fucked with a Knife on the pool deck, dedicating it to all the ladies. I mean, that was awesome. And just really the camaraderie of just hanging out with all these metalheads from all over the world.
And
awesome people, awesome times, lots of boozing. We'll do it again.
And we ate a lot.
Yeah. Well, Noah ate a lot. I'm
you
on
ate
it.
A lot, too.
Don't talk about me. Anyway, we're running.
You put that other entree with me.
Yeah, look, this it didn't happen on camera, so it just didn't happen. Anyway, we're running out of time here. We're going to get out of here. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you soon.